On Sunday, June 23, 2019, at the New Land in Taiwan, also known as Formosa, our beloved Supreme Master Ching Hai shared some valuable reminders with us, particularly in regards to asceticism and practicing spiritually for true liberation.
It's not like any master at all had to be an ascetic. It doesn't have to be that way. But if you can, just simplify your life. Whatever you need, keep. What you don't need, give it away, sell it if it's not useful anymore. Simplify your life whenever you can, wherever you can. You can have many things, but it doesn't mean you are mundanely bound. So important is that you have to remember the inside, not the outside appearance or actions, but your inside, your heart, your motivation, okay? Your goal. What is it that you want in life? There's only one way to do things is the right way. There's only one way, the correct way. And the Kuan Yin method is the correct way to get enlightenment. I mean the real one, the ultimate one, and the right one. Buddha said that, huh? Don't think I tried to convince you. Yeah. All the masters say the same thing. If you have time to study all the scriptures here and there, they mention like that. The more we hear this teaching, inner teaching, or our own true nature, the more we understand many things. Yes. The more we will feel free. The more we feel that we are nearer to Buddhahood or nearer to heaven, or maybe already with heaven. With God, one with God. That's the only way.
Master then continued with Lord Mahavira's remarkable story, clarifying why she chose to read it to us.
I don't know if anyone in the history of mankind could have done, or could be doing, or will be doing such an asceticism, such a sacrifice like the Lord Mahavira. Okay? That's why I want to read it to you.
After explaining how the great Lord Mahavira, who gave up life as a prince as well as all his possessions and clothes, vowed to be a renunciate in front of thousands of witnesses, Master read the following.
After the austere vow, the Mahasraman, meaning the great Swami, the great monk, they call him now, acquired Manapayavichanan, which allow him to perceive the feelings and thoughts of all beings. He has some psychic power now, yeah? Just like in knowing the thought of others. His heart was filled with equanimity and compassion. His face beamed with a spontaneous smile. Why does he feel compassion after he have this power? Because he can feel what the humans or all beings around him or in the world feel. You know, their sorrow, their pain, their frustration, their troubles, their helplessness, their suffering. That's why he has compassion for them. Sometimes the masters, they all have all this. Just sometimes they have to shut it down, otherwise they cannot continue to do their job. The sympathy they have for all beings will collapse them mentally, emotionally, psychically, and bodily as well. No one can be able to really function well in this world, no matter how strong spiritually, if that person continues to open this faculty, psychic power, and hearing all the suffering of the world.
Our gratitude evermore to all the past, present, and future masters, Buddhas, and saints who through their immense sacrifice have come to our physical world to save suffering beings and help them achieve eternal liberation, a task only the spiritually resilient, selfless, and pure-hearted can do. Most precious Master, we humbly thank you for teaching us about the many cherished masters, such as the venerated Lord Mahavira, who have graced our planet. These accounts provide us with more strength and inspiration to improve and be more resolute in our spiritual practice. May our beloved Master remain in excellent health, live long, and be forever protected by the mighty heavens. For the full broadcast of this lecture by Supreme Master Ching Hai, please tune in to Between Master and Disciples at a later date.